Welcome back. And in April 2018, Studio 10 got a new and extremely funny co-host when Denise Scott joined the show.
She had us in absolute stitches, and the laughs continued when she took on the mantle of Melbourne Correspondent, really changing the face of journalism forever. Let's take a look at Scotty's time on Studio 10.
Hello there, Denise Scott, Melbourne correspondent for Studio 10. I've done some tough assignments. I had my date with The Bachelor. I walked the catwalk with a model. But now, here I am at the Royal Melbourne Show. I got that sunshine in my
pocket. Got that good soul in my feet. This is Teddy, who just did a big poo.
What are you talking about?
No, no, to the knows. End. No,
could it just be about me?
Sorry. Didn't your dad used to work at the National Gallery?
What the hell is going on?
Is your dad an artist?
My dad delivered small goods, Frankfurts, in a van. If you call that artistry, this show is off to a cracking start. I'm not just one of your many toys. I've got Matt here. Come in.
There he is.
Oh, is that producer Matt Simpson in Melbourne? What happened? What did you do?
But is it working?
Yeah, it's working now. Yeah, we can
hear
you.
Okay, enough, Matt. Move out now. Move away, Matt. Move away.
Make them laugh. Make them laugh.
I had a sitcom cancelled as well. You know, and I'm in my 60s, so it's like, you know, as if I'm going to get one up now before I cark it. But
hey, the Golden Girls is pretty good.
It's not my sitcom, Sarah. And they said, you know, you mustn't take it personally. And I'm like, my sitcom was about a 60-year-old female comic and it was called Denise. I had to take it personally.
I get the tram a lot in Melbourne and I got on, this woman sat opposite me and she was looking at me, you know, looking at me. And finally she said, look, I know you from somewhere. And I'm like, I'll just cut straight to the chase. I said, look, I'm Denise Scott. I'm like, you probably know me from TV. And she went, nah. And then she went, do you get this tram a lot? And I went, yeah. And she went, that's where I'm going. Yes, it's true.
I haven't been out of the house this lockdown. I've been very much at home, but I had to go to the gynecologist.
Oh.
I had to have a follow-up procedure, and I think you know what I'm talking about. But let's just say, beautiful gynecologist Dr. Jane did use the word atrophied. Now, I know. That's the part of my, that part of my body is atrophied. Is it too early in the morning? Who cares? But I just want to say I'm glad it wasn't my arms. Well, I can knit, I can crochet. Who cares about the other bit? John and I are just a relationship trial.
Jeepers, creepers. Where'd you get those eyes?
Oh! I can now see why Scotty thought a trip to the gynecologist was a whole lot of fun.
And I think the question is, will the relationship survive? And this is what love is, people.
Overzealous, play hard to get females get jealous. Okay, smarty.
So having all your family there for that. Well, that was the night I scored a one. This is clear guilt. He's clearly up to something with Sharon on the webinar. What do we do now? What if we never see each other again?
From the morning. Hey, Scotty, from Melbourne. Good to see you.
Oh, and good to see all of you. And I'm not Jennifer Kite. I have to say, I'm sitting in Jennifer Kite's chair in the newsroom in Melbourne. So just to clarify, it's Denise Scott here.
Your journalism career is really soaring to new heights. Scotty, we've missed you so much. We wish you could have you, we could have you in Sydney, but unfortunately, Greater Sydney is now in lockdown. You know the feeling. You kept us entertained. But you've debuted new hair as well.
I have. Check it out. Look, this is lockdown hair. I've stopped dyeing my hair. What a liberation it is. And you know what? The makeup artists all go, oh, it looks great. So, you know, there's a lot of positivity coming here. But I literally, because Melbourne has been in and out of lockdown, it just got too much for me and I've let it go.
I think you're rocking it, girlfriend. We are looking back at some of your best moments on the show, and you have provided us with so, so many, including the time that I had a case of the giggles and you stepped in to cover for me. Look at this.
Thanks for watching. Stay alive.
Do you want me to take over? We know they pose a huge risk to native wildlife. I'll do it like Sarah. But no, cats and their owners are being targeted by a Sydney... What?
Yeah, it's harder than you think, isn't it, Scotty?
Council! I thought it said couch!
Look out, Jennifer Kite. I reckon you can do that gig, Scotty. Hey, you really got to thrive as our Melbourne correspondent. Mm-hmm. Some correspondents, like, you know, Yarn Event, we go to war zones and whatever. Yes. But you covered the big stories, like the Royal Melbourne Show. Let's take a look.
Is that a goat?
Well, that's why I bring that particular one. It's a Persian sheep and it's a desert sheep. And you can see he's got fat underneath his chin and fat on his tail. When the conditions turn bad, he's able to live off the condition of his body.
So if things go awry, I'm in good shape, Father Darrell.
Well, we both are. We'd be right for, you know, maybe a 10-year drought for sure.
Speak for yourself. But nothing could have prepared me for an encounter with Lily the Llama. Oh, hello, beautiful. I'm married. Well, sort of. Actually, we just live together. Lily, I'm also heterosexual. But thank you. I appreciate the interest. This is one of the most intimate moments I've had in years. Well, here I am in the dog's pavilion with Darren, the dog breeder, stroke handler, stroke show-er, and of course, Melody here.
Yes, the gorgeous unchained Melody, who won her intermediate bitch class today at the Melbourne Royal.
Did you know she was an intermediate bitch when you first saw Melody?
She's a beautiful bitch, and she's...
I'm sorry, Darren. I've tried to keep this together.
Scotty.
I know what I bring to the job. I mean, you know, Lily just kept wanting to pash me. I had llama pash rash for weeks after that.